To serve the gold fields, a reliable railroad was needed. But who could drive steel through the White Pass, which offered nothing but seemingly impossible grades and cliffs of solid granite? Construction began May 27, 1898, after a chance meeting in Skagway between railroad builder Sir Thomas Tancred and Canadian engineer Michael J. Heaney. Sir Thomas obtained British financial backing, and the White Pass and Yukon Railway was no longer a dream, but an engineering challenge that would demand everything Big Mike Heaney had to offer, and more besides. With nothing but horses, shovels, black powder, and men, the right-of-way was blasted and hacked through the pass. The railway was one of the most difficult ever engineered, as massive grades and buttresses of solid rock barred the way. 35,000 men were employed on construction. Among them were doctors, lawyers, scholars, and ministers, making the most educated group of construction workers ever assembled. Attracted north by the rush for gold, many landed in Skagway dead broke. With wages earned on the railroad, they purchased their outfits and headed for the Klondike. On July 21st, 1898, the first train was placed in service and operated a distance of 4 miles.
Back in 98, they hit the Wild Goose Trail. Led them to Alaska shores where many men would fail. They toiled across the mountains to the Klondike. They set forth, crossed 1,000 miles or more to build a brave new north. The land was like a woman, she would rule your life. Many miners married her that never had a wife. They dug for gold till hope rose cold each morning. They set forth, crossed 1,000 miles or more to build a brave new north.
To build a brave new north. To build a brave new north. They crossed 1,000 miles or more to build a brave new
Containers for onward shipment to distant Yukon points are loaded directly onto trucks. They are then dispatched to Dawson City, Mayo, Watson Lake, and all highway communities.
On Vancouver's waterfront, barge loads of railroad rolling stock make ready for the voyage north.